We're going to start off with the Crawford Songbirds in the direction to Steady McDowell. They will be joined after them later on by the Wolfie Dragons from Southeast, and also later on by the Skyview Collectors. Right now we have the Crawford Songbirds.
Above the roof. too. All right, I'm going to need some help for some of these things. Anybody like to help me with this? Yeah? All right, everybody, come on up. No, I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. I'm just kidding. We'll see you nice and quiet, then we'll get some help about that stuff. Yeah? Alright, we'll see you nice and quiet. Are you guys ready? Can you hear me okay? Is that good? Test 1, 2. A little louder? Yeah, you good? Test 1, 2. Alright, you guys ready? Alright, let's do this. This goes here. It goes there. One of these, one of those. How many have seen me before? How many here last year? Ooh, really good. How many never seen me before? A lot. How many wish they never seen me? All right, we're good. Let's go. Ready? Music. Oh, wait, I don't have any. Okay, here we go. Watch. 1. Right? It gets better seeing me, it gets a little better. Oh, who's the dog now? I know, right? That's not real magic, right? But I'm going to turn around and see if you guys can catch me, okay? You're going to see this from behind the magician. Can you all see the tissue? All right, watch close. You're going to see this from behind the magician. Watch here. Keep your eye on it. It's still here where you can see it. Right there? Keep your eye on it. It's right up here. Up here? See it right here? It's gone. Where'd it go? No. No, it's not in the purple. I didn't see it in the purple room. I didn't see it in the purple. No, it's not in the room. I didn't see it in the first room. And then I went to the whole floor. It's not in the room. In my mouth, you guys are right. That's 2-6 for people going. All right, we're gonna go fast, guys. We got a lot to do in a half hour. Let me see. I should make sure you guys are paying attention. Here, this is my paying attention card. My wife said, take me someplace expensive. I took her to a gas station. She said, no, someplace I've never been. I said, I want the kitchen. Knock yourself out. All right, just making sure the adults are skinny. Is this on? All right, one spot on this side. 4 on this side, 3 over here, 6 on this side, you got it? 4 sides, 1 over here, 4 on this side, 3 over here, 6 over here. I know what you're thinking, I am really good. All right, I'm gonna show you how to make one of these. On this side, 2 spots. If you cover this one, you tell everybody it's only 1, they can't do the one under here. If you hold it over here, you tell them 3, and they think there's 1 here. So actually there's 2, you make it look like 1, and 3. On the other side, you put 5, if you cover the space, it looks like 6. If you cover the spot, it looks like? You're confused. Right, okay, how many are on this side here? 2, good. You got it? 3! Right, 3, my bad. And this side is? 5. Sometimes, right. Okay, 6, whatever. Okay, 3 on this side, the other side has? 8, right, we got it, we're good? Okay, terrific. All right, let's get a helper up here. Have you been up here yet? You're not coming either. I'm just kidding, sweaty. Sweetie. I meant sweetie. Come on up here, little brat. I mean, cute little girl. What's your name? Kaden? Kaden with an H. Kaden. Have we met before? How do you know it's me? Okay, here we go. How old are you, Hayden? 7. You're not married, right? No? Okay, good. Boyfriend? No? Okay, just checking. All right, Hayden, this is what we got. We got 1, 2, put them here so they don't blow away. 3, this one goes here. Actually, I'll hold these 2, you hold this one. Hang on tight, get it, okay? All right, this one goes here. This ball goes here. When I count to... You think it jumped in your hand. Oh, you got it. Okay, I thought I lost it. Hey, yeah, don't do that, kid. Yeah, put this here. This one, you hold this one here. Hang on really tight, you got it tight? All right, 1 here, 2, and you have 3. Okay, what's going to happen? Yeah, don't do that, okay? When you're racing, you have 20, yeah, don't do that, don't do that. Okay, we'll do it like this. One, two, I'll put one in my pocket. Now these two, no, sorry. One, two, right, one in my pocket. Now these two, no, sorry. One, two, is this too fast? I can slow it down. A little bit fast. Hayden, Hayden, Hayden with a H. One, two, can you hold three?
Could this thing last? evening. My name is Gene Ledger, U.S. Army veteran. 13 years ago, in 2002, Donna Allen got a group of veterans together and called us the International Veterans Chorus. Our first song is my favorite. This is America. Soloist will be Francis Water. He served in the Japan Ground Defense Forces.
United States Army, and Joe Deagle, United States Navy.
Start with tomorrow. crusader will be strong and stand with thee. Beyond the barricade, is there a world you long to see? Then join in the fight that will give you the right to be free.
Olympic Centennial. So tonight, receiving those awards first is Wendy Weeks. Wendy, where are you? Wendy Weeks, come on up. As you know, Wendy works at City Hall. She's worked for the senator, she's worked for the congressman, and there's nothing. And when I think of Leominster, this is what I think of. Somebody that, when somebody needs help or somebody's working on something, she's the first person to raise her hand and say, just count me in. And so a lot of the work that she does, I get the credit for. She does the work. So tonight, on behalf of the Starburst Committee, everybody here in the city of Leominster, she has a very nice write-up in there. It was going to take 2 pages, but they only gave her one because they couldn't fit it all. But let's give a big round of applause to Wendy Weeks. Citizen of the Year, 2015, in recognition of your personal dedication, service, and devotion to the city and its citizens, its way of life. That explains Wendy, her way of life. Leominster the first, her way of life. Congratulations, Wendy. Our congressman couldn't be here tonight, but he has very special relationship with Wendy as well, and so he gave this certificate here of special congressional recognition, presented to Wendy Weeks in recognition of outstanding and invaluable service to the city of Leominster. Signed, Jim McGovern. Hold on. And we all chipped in, Wendy, to get you some flowers.
As a lifelong resident of Leominster, I guess I started early. I started delivering papers for the Sentinel. And I'd go house to house and talk to everybody, and I really like talking to people. So then, this is really strange. So then I went to work. I worked with three terrific people. I worked for our member of Congress, John Oliver, and then Senator Bob Antonioni. And now I work for this guy who, I never thought I'd see someone with so much energy, but he truly does. And I love working as part of a team at City Hall. And my co-workers are here, Kelly, Michelle, and Colleen. And we truly have fun, and I'm really honored to be part of this night. For not only is it our 100th as a city, but to be included in a group of people that like Louis Charpentier and John and Ellie DeLibero and the people who are escorting me out here tonight is really an honor. So thank you very much, and I have to say hi to my mom and Esther over there. So thank you very much.
Our other recipient this year is as humble as one can imagine. He just appears when help is needed. He's a hard worker. I don't think he sleeps. He's just up all the time. He has an incredible resume if you look in the book, but he keeps, and I think somewhat started the tradition of community service, because if your name is LeBlanc in Leominster and you come from this family, then half of your life is spent in community service. So anyway, imagine being part of an organization where you give hundreds of hours to this organization for free. How about imagining giving somebody or an organization hundreds of hours for free for 50 years? 50 years. Can you imagine 50 years? That's amazing. And this guy, I don't care what storm it was, he managed to be the vice president and run a big operation over at Boston Tech. At the same time, he was at our emergency management, helping us to manage the team. And I know for sure he didn't sleep. So anyway, let's give a huge round of applause to Jim LeBlanc. Your brother said he's only seen you get mad once. And I said, I wouldn't have wanted to be around. But all I know is this guy smiles. Him and Wendy smile all the time. So and let me just say, you could, this, the committee picks, the committee chooses each year who becomes the Citizens of the Year. You couldn't have picked two finer people than you picked this year. Amazing. So thank you to the committee. Jim, on behalf of the Starburst Committee, the Citizens of Lumminster, the City Council, myself, it gives me great honor to present you with the Lumminster Citizen of the Year 2015, James LeBlanc, in recognition of your personal dedication, service, and devotion to this city, its citizens, and its way of life. Congratulations. And also from our Congressman, Jim McGovern, a certificate of special congressional recognition. Thank you so much for all you do for the city. You can say whatever you want. After 50 years, you can play the banjo if you want.
Don't worry, this will be really short. I'm deeply honored to be recognized as the Lumminster Citizen of the Year. My good friend Jim Lanciani came to me over an emergency management one night about a week ago. He says, "Congratulations, Jim." I'm kind of looking at Jim kind of strange saying, "For what?" He says, "You've just been nominated for Citizen of the Year." I go, "No way." And that is really an honor. I'm really humbled by the selection. When you think of how many hundreds of volunteers there are in the city, and how many great things that they've done for the community. And I'd just like to take a moment also that how important this award is when you think that Mr. Christmas was the first recipient back years ago, and what he meant to the city. And here he was just passing at 104. So what a tradition. I've been very lucky in life to have volunteered for the last 50 years. It makes me think, how do I pass on the volunteer activities to the younger kids? As it was 50 years ago in 1965, when I was in high school, that I first joined. I had a lot of good mentors in school at CTE that allowed me to get into the program, and I got into Foster Grant in 1965, mainly because of the guidance and mentoring from the CTE drafting teacher.
Enjoy the fireworks.
Thank you. Thank you.